My name is Manfred. I'm a member of the VSL team since approximately a year now. And I'm the main developer of the Synchron Harp. For the play itself, one of the major challenges was the design of the graphical user interface, because the player has two different modes in which you can play the harp. One is the pedal mode, where you have all these controls, where you can set the tonal center and the scales you want to use and all the pedal settings. And then if you switch to the chromatic mode, where you don't need all that, what do you do with the empty space? So we went through some iterations with our design team to get that working, really. Yeah. Another thing was the color scheme. We opted for a color scheme which is maybe a little bit unusual for a harp instrument. We wanted the color scheme to invoke a similar emotion as the sound of the harp itself. So we went for something that suggests it's airy and angelic and spiritual, yeah. And we wanted to transport this emotion already with the user interface. Well, the first steps that I took when starting the project were really watching videos of harpists play the harp. I wanted to learn how do you, these musicians use their instrument? What are the things they're playing? You know? How do they play them? You know? Why were these special techniques picked during the recording sessions? And so this was basically the start for me, watching a lot of videos about harpists. The next steps with developing the player were to sit together with the other people of the development team and the big boss, of course, to define what are the features of the player. What do we want to make this product do? And one of the decisions that we took was we want to have a player which you can use for live playing. So it's not just about using it as a plugin in a digital audio workstation and using a sequencer and using MIDI notes, but we wanted to have a player where you can really sit down with a hardware keyboard and start playing glissandi on the white keys. And we took quite some measures to make that happen and make that possible. Well, my favorite feature of the new player is actually one of the scales. I really love the whole tone scale. It sounds so mystical and whimsical a little bit. During programming the player, I found myself repeatedly going back to the whole tone scale and just playing glissandi on my keyboard and just enjoying the sound of it. So that's my favorite feature. There is one special feature that I want to draw attention to, which is a little bit of a hidden feature. In the main graphical user interface, when you open it, it opens in pedal mode, and you see buttons for the 7 pedals. There are 2 small dots underneath, and you can switch there to a different representation of the pedals. And the second representation that I have there is the so-called pedal diagram, which is used in harp notation. So if you're curious about how sheet music for harpists looks like, you can have a peek there. Maybe one thing that may be unique about our player is that we have a lot of buttons where you can save pedalings to. The reason for that is, as I said before, we want to have this player usable in a live playing setting. Yeah? And so you can prepare the piece you're playing and prepare the pedalings beforehand and save them in the buttons. And then you have a stepper, so you have a key switch, and just with one keystroke, you change to the next pedaling. And again, the same keystroke, next pedaling. This is something that we borrowed from the organ player. We had a similar feature there, and we chose to reuse it in the harp player to facilitate live playing.